This is an Ethernet cable. It's how devices can communicate to the network and internet, sending packets to and from each other in order to accomplish tasks. Ordinarily, you'd have to plug this into magnetics, a PHY, and a Mac before you'd be able to send or receive any packets. Except for me, in which case you just cut a bunch of the wires off and you wire two of them into this little ATTiny85 here. They're actually the RX wires on the switch end, so they're TX from the AVR. As you can probably guess, that means this is simplex. You can only send packets. I have here a simplified diagram where you can see the wires coming into the AVR. There is absolutely no passives, and two switches on these two pins right here in order to be able to detect when a pin is clicked or not. So let's go plug this in right now. Let's see here. Let me just plug it in that port there. And you can see it started linking at 10 megabits per second. It's currently sending packets over to my computer right here. So the packets are coming in, each packet is a dot, and if I click the switch right here, it starts sending a different kind of packet. I can actually detect when this switch is clicked or this switch is clicked in order to send a different value. So let's get a little bit more into how this works. When you're running off of a power supply, I'm running it at 4.6 volts, it actually uses less than 10 milliamps, so I dare say this might be the simplest and lowest power Ethernet-enabled device I'm aware of. 10 base T is particularly convenient for this because it operates at, you guessed it, 10 megahertz, and it's a very simple encoding scheme. So, first part that I have to worry about is the media detection, and that's very simple. All we have to do is send one of these ticks every 16 milliseconds, and the switch will recognize us as an Ethernet-enabled switch. The next one is send the packet. This could be particularly difficult if we were trying to do something clever, but you'll see later on, we're not. So really all it is just a series of highs and lows, and it has to be differential signaling. That's why we need to have two wires. So whenever one wire goes high, the other one goes low, and vice versa. And we send a sequence. If the signal goes from high to low, then we're sending a 1. If it goes from a low to a high, then we're sending a 0. And so the beginning of the message is called a preamble. We send a series of 1s and 0s and 1s and 0s, and it's a fairly low frequency wave. This ends up working out to about 5 megahertz. Then, when we're ready to actually go send the message, we go switch around to having a series of 0s and then the message. So it goes from high-low, low-high, high-low, low-high, to high-low, low-high, 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 low, and then whatever rest of the Ethernet message we want to send. Since we're not actually doing anything clever here, really all we're doing is just pre-writing all of the packets. There's only three packets, so they conveniently fit inside of the RAM. And then I go convert this packet into raw assembly code, where it sets up some stuff, and then it proceeds to, one byte after the next, flip the output pins backwards and forwards. So all I'm doing here is just one instruction after another, each being issued at one clock cycle at 20 megahertz, switching the two pins, differential output pins, on port B backwards and forwards. So this right here is what it takes in order to go even be able to send three packets. It uses about 7 kilobytes. For the actual code, all I do is I set up the clock, sets it to 20 megahertz. This is different on each AVR, probably temperature and unstable, and makes it completely unsuitable for any kind of practical real-world application. Really, don't use this project. And then down here, set up the outputs, look at the switches, and every so often, send A packet if the switch is down, B packet if the other switch is down, or C packet all the time, no matter what. All of the source code is available on GitHub. But really, I do want to urge that you should never, ever use this, and this project should probably go die in a fire. Okay, have fun!